Hidayah merupakan petunjuk hidup yang diberikan Allah kepada setiap manusia. Hidayah sendiri merupakan rahasia Allah yang akan Allah berikan kepada orang-orang yang Ia kehendaki. Bagi siapapun yang mau menjemput hidayah tersebut ke dalam dirinya, hidayah adalah salah satu bukti kekuasaan Allah terhadap hambanya. Allah sang pemilik dunia dan juga pemilik seluruh alam semesta. Datangnya hidayah tentu juga bergantung pada kehendaknya dan akan diterima oleh hamba yang dikehendakinya pula. Sebagaimana terdapat di dalam Al-Quran, yaitu surat Al-Qasas ayat 56. Allah berfirman, sesungguhnya engkau tidak akan dapat memberi hidayah kepada orang yang kamu kasihi, tetapi Allah memberi hidayah kepada orang yang Ia kehendaki, dan Allah mengetahui orang-orang yang mau menerima petunjuk. Joshua Evan adalah seorang mantan misionaris Kristen dan menteri pemuda dari negara bagian South Carolina yang telah memeluk agama Islam. Ia dilahirkan pada tahun 1978 di Greenville, South Carolina, Amerika Serikat. Ia dilahirkan dalam sebuah keluarga Kristen yang sangat konservatif. Pada awal masa remajanya, ia banyak terlibat dan sangat aktif dalam kegiatan gereja di dekat rumahnya dan juga di sebuah organisasi yang bernama Young Life, yaitu sebuah organisasi yang berorientasikan pemuda non-denominasi di dalam kegiatan pelayanan, mengajar, dan berkhotbah di gereja-gereja kekristenan di Amerika Serikat. Setelah lulus SMA pada tahun 1996, ia bermaksud mendaftar di Bob Jones University, yaitu sebuah sekolah Alkitab yang terkenal di dunia, yang berada di kota kelahirannya di South Carolina, Amerika Serikat. Dan pada musim panas di tahun 1996 tersebut, mulai mengubah hidupnya. Setelah ia banyak mempelajari Alkitab lebih mendalam, ia mulai menyadari begitu banyak hal miring dan kontradiksi di dalam Alkitab, serta banyak hal yang tidak sejalan dengan apa yang ia yakini selama ini. Dalam penelitiannya saat memperdalam Alkitab dan kekristenan secara menyeluruh, dan akhirnya ia meninggalkan agama Kristen dan pergi mencari kebenaran. Lalu ia pun mempelajari serta mendalami banyak agama lainnya, sampai akhirnya ia bertemu dengan seorang Muslim, dan orang tersebut menghadiahinya sebuah Al-Quran. Lalu ia membacanya. Setelah ia membaca dan mempelajari isi Al-Quran secara menyeluruh, akhirnya ia pun menjadi seorang Muslim. Tepatnya pada musim dingin di tahun 1998. Dan kini ia menjadi seorang dosen di sebuah universitas di Amerika, serta mengajar lokakarya yang dapat membawanya berkeliling dunia. Ia pun mendirikan stasiun televisi Islam di Amerika Utara yang juga dapat ditonton oleh para penontonnya di segala penjuru dunia. Ia juga aktif berdakwah kepada orang-orang di Amerika yang ingin mempelajari agama Islam, sehingga banyak dari mereka yang juga akhirnya memeluk agama Islam dan juga mengajak orang-orang Muslim lainnya untuk memperkuat akidah mereka dengan mengamalkan isi Al-Quran dan hadis, serta melaksanakan sunnah Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ia pun belajar ke banyak cendekiawan Muslim untuk mempelajari berbagai ilmu Islam lainnya. Ia telah meraih gelar sarjana dan master di bidang ilmu-ilmu Islam dengan spesialisasi dalam dakwah atau propagasi Islam, dan kini ia sedang mengejar gelar doktornya di bawah bimbingan Syekh Walid Al-Manisi, yaitu salah satu sarjana ulama terkemuka di dunia.
Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la syarika lah, wa asyhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu wa khataman nabiyyin wa rahmatul lil alamin wa da'iyan ila Allah bi idznihi wa sirajan munira. Amma ba'd. I'm going to tell you tonight about my journey from where I once was as a former Christian youth minister to how I got to where I am now. There's a lot of bumps in the road, you know, it seems pretty clear, yeah, you're a minister and now you're Muslim, you know, but there's a little bit more to it, inshallah, so just bear with me and hopefully you'll get something out of it, because the point is at the end is I want you to get the message behind the story, because if I was traveling around the country just to tell my story, then I would be wasting time. It's on YouTube, anyone can go get it from anywhere in the world. So inshallah, we're going to begin at the beginning. I was born and raised in Greenville, South Carolina. And I was raised by my grandparents, because at a very early age, my mother had stepped out and my father was working two jobs. So it was me and my grandparents. And my grandparents were the traditional conservative Southern Christian folk, as they say. They were very, very conservative in their ideals and their ideologies, in their ways. You know, as you hear about, you know, people being set in their ways, that was my grandparents. Like, we did it this way, and this is the way you did it every single day, and that was it. And we were very religious in the sense that we went to church on Sundays, we went to church Sunday evenings, we went to church Wednesday. And in Christianity, that's considered very religious. And it was not hard for us to go to church, and it was not difficult for my grandmother to drag me to church every Sunday, which as a kid is what they had to do, because the church was two houses down from our house. There was two houses and then there was the church. So it was not hard for them to drag me every Sunday. And I hated church as a kid because of the simple reason that, you know, we were brought up United Methodist. And Methodist is, for any of you know, it's very traditional. It's not like you think about like screaming and shouting in church and all that. No, you listen to the preacher, you sit, stand up and you sing, you sit back down, you listen to the preacher, you stand up and sing, you sit back down, listen to the preacher, and that's it. That's all that happens. And the pews, as they call them, the chairs are made out of wood, they're hard. You get tired of sitting there, you're fumbling around, playing with the money that my grandmother gave me to put in the offering plate, all of these things. That's what I remember from church as a very small boy. But the thing that I do remember enjoying about church was Sunday school. Sunday school is what I got enjoyment from, because went to Sunday school, you painted pictures, you know, of like Noah building the ark, you painted, you know, all these pictures of Moses splitting the Red Sea. You learned the stories of Moses freeing the children of Israel from Egypt. You learned the story about him splitting the Red Sea. You learned the story about Noah and the ark. You learned the story about David and Goliath. You know, you learn all these beautiful stories in Sunday school. So this was basically, as coming up, this is what I knew about Christianity, was the stories that I learned in Sunday school, because I never listened to the preacher during regular service. So that was the only thing I knew about Christianity. So coming up, this was how it was. It was just the norm. And the conservatism in my house, just to give you an example, and about the level of conservatism, is, if let's talk about gender issues. Let's say when I became 12, 13, 14, and I started to actually, you know, notice females, and I actually didn't think they had diseases and wanted to run away from them every time I saw them. Let's say I wanted to have a girl over or something of this nature. It was so serious to my grandmother that I had to make an appointment with her, let her know this girl was coming to my house. We had to sit in the formal living room, which in the South, I don't know how it is here, but you have the dining room, then you have the formal living room with all the nice stuff that you don't go in unless there's company over. And my grandmother either had to be sitting in the same room with us or in the kitchen where she could see directly in the room. I mean, this is just how it was in my house. This is how my grandmother and grandfather were. They were very stern. They were very loving, but there were rules, and those rules were the way they were, and they did not change. So this was my upbringing. And I would say at about the age of 12, 13, 14, more along the age 13, 14, I started going to the Saturday evening youth services at my church that were for 12 and up. And the youth services were held in the gym, and they were totally different than church. At the youth services, you went, we played basketball, we played volleyball, we played dodgeball, you know, we played every kind of sport, and we ate pizza and cake and candy, you know, all the stuff kids like to do. And at the end, the youth minister, who happened to be my catty corner neighbor across the street. When I was 14, he was 17. He was the youth minister, so he would sit us down and give us a 30-minute lecture about Christianity, about something about God. Doing, you know, he would give us a 30-minute sermon, and that's how the youth services were. And going to these youth services, I met some other people who went to other youth services. They invited me to Young Men for Christ and other things that were going on in South Carolina. And so I started to go to these different retreats and camping trips with them. And so that is when I would say that I started to become a Christian out of will. I became a Christian because I wanted to, not because it was something I was dragged to do. I started to actually want to be Christian. This is something I wanted to do. I made my own choice and my own decision to do it. So when I turned 15, I started going to high school. And when I was in a freshman in high school, my best friend, who was the youth minister, was a senior in high school. And I remember we had a very close bond because I had not had my license yet. So I used to ride with him to school every day. And it was a big deal for me to be able to ride to school with a senior, especially since he had a brand new, or it was a brand new, but he had a restored 67 Mustang, which I've always been a fan of cars when I was a kid. So we had a very close bond, and we were very good friends because both of our parents were very similar. They didn't let us do much. So we spent a lot of time with each other. And when I became a sophomore, he graduated and started to attend Bob Jones University. I don't know if that rings a bell with anyone, but Bob Jones University is a very prestigious conservative Christian college in South Carolina. It's probably the most conservative college I've ever seen, because the Moody Institute is known as one of the most famous in this country since Chicago. But Bob Jones is conservative to the point to where when it comes to men and women, like men and women aren't allowed to get caught talking to each other in a room alone if they're not married, holding hands on campus. The men had to wear button-up shirts or polo shirts tucked in with slacks or jeans. The women had to wear skirts, no jeans, skirts that came down to the ankle and a shirt that came to the wrist. And this was part of the guidelines for Bob Jones University. You know, you didn't party, you didn't drink, there was none of this that happened at Bob Jones University. And he started going there, and his major was textual criticism. And textual criticism probably doesn't ring a bell with anyone, and to explain it in detail would probably take another entire lecture. But just to give you a brief synopsis of what is textual criticism, a textual critic takes the ancient manuscripts of the Bible, the pieces of parchment that were found all over the world, and he has to learn Hebrew, Greek, Aramaic, Latin, you know, these languages that these parchments have been found in. And he has to take these scriptures and try to find out where they came from, why there are variations in the many different versions of the same parchment. Let's say you have Matthew chapter 1 from the Bible. There might be 5,000 different variant readings of Matthew chapter 1 in 6 languages. And so he has to be able to take all these and sift through them, try to find out why there's so many variations of the readings, and then determine which one is the original. To say this is the testament of who the man was, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is such a beautiful thing to be able to be part of this great religion, this great way of life, with such a great guidance from the Creator in the Book of Allah and in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my attraction to Islam was the Quran, and it still is the Quran, inshallah, and will always be, because this is the foundation of everything that we have, is the book, the communication to the Creator. It has been a pleasure to be with you. My name is Yusha Evans again for Quran Weekly. Saying Jazakallah Khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.